baby. Oh, yes. Oh. There, there. Oh, no, there. Ooh, oh. Ooh. Oh. Oh, baby. You are the greatest. This has got to be the best night of my life.
I need more, Larry. More. And something new. Here, slip into these.
God, Shamra, is there anything we haven't done?
There's lots I haven't done, Laffer. That's why I'm leaving you.
Leaving? Now?
A night with you gives a woman plenty of time to think. All that New Age philosophy crap just isn't me. What I really love is money.
You can't leave me here like this.
You're right. So long, sucker.
Hey, I don't smoke. Oh, baby, you are the lowest. This has got to be the worst night of my life.
Well, at least things can't get any worse. I should never say that. My comb-over could use a little thickening.
Attention, attention.
It's a good thing Shamra used those vice grips last night. I can just reach them from here.
Me?
Yes, you. The person who spent the night with Shamra.
Who put that
Leave
there?
Leave now. We think there may be a fire somewhere.
Oh. Good thing you wore your industrial strength extra absorbent underwear. You open the La Castellata complimentary Lil Hair Weave kit and find a needle inside. It's about as bent as it's going to get. There's no way your vice grips are strong enough. Those grips spell vice with a C, not an S.
Maybe.
Yes! Crazy? This is the 40th floor!
Don't you worry! We've got the net here!
Hotel furniture just ain't what it used to be. Lovemaking must have overheated the frame.
Yeah, right. You can't lift that, Larry. It must weigh all of 20 pounds.
glass door there, select Other from the menu. In the resulting dialog box, type in the word break.
What's this?
Ow! I hate paper cuts. Ow! I hate paper cuts!
Yomp! Yomp!
Okay, I'm coming.
I wish I had for myself a dollar every time I've heard that.
Just leapt from the 40th floor of a burning building. What are you gonna do next?
I'm going to take a cruise. Boat babes, my name is Larry. Larry Laffer.
Welcome aboard the PMS Bouncy, Laffer. I'm Captain Thigh.
Before this cruise is over, she'll be falling all over me. Here's your key card, Mr. Laffer. There's been a slight problem with your room. I kind of expected that. Oh, not to worry. I took the liberty of substituting our largest cabin.
You'll have plenty of room.
Wow, that's super. Thanks. Now, where would my room be?
Oh, just check the map.
You're in room 0.
You insert your key card into the slot with great anticipation. What will your special suite be like?
Cybersmith 2000.
You're a Zetchus Blink.
Yeah, baby!
Why would you to spend next week humbling the captain? Please report immediately to the ship's lounge.
This little giant safety shower was built according to the traditional principles of design and workmanship of the master craftsman of Vrohuti.
Well, that's good.
Not that good. Their traditional principle is, make it last until the warranty expires.
Oh. Hey, wait. When will that be?
Give or take a week?
Sure.
About 12 years ago.
Did I say, doh?
You've been provided with the finest in Army surplus cots.
Well, that's good.
Not that good. It's from the Uzbekistan Army, and the only reason it's surplus is because sleeping on it is less comfortable than sleeping on frozen tundra.
Doh.
Now the toilet drains freely.
Well, that's good.
Not that good. It hasn't been connected to a water pipe in 34 years.
Oh.
There's a few chairs there in the back. Oh, never mind. If you're not seated by now, just stand. I'm sure Captain Thigh will be pleased as punch to see such a good turnout this week. And as you all know, each week she runs a little competition for her male, or male-like, passengers, which she calls the Thigh's Man Trophy Contest. Isn't that cute? Of course, there's no actual trophy involved. No, what you win is better than hardware. One of you will spend next week cruising on the captain. I mean, that is. She'll treat you to a one-week cruise in her cabin where your every need will be met. Uh-huh. By now, each of you has received your personal scorecard listing a random set of events the computer assigned you. Now, don't you worry, okay? No one has to enter every event. There's just too many. Just find the ones listed on your scorecard, enter, and win. The man with the highest total score wins. Are there any questions?
Are there any answers?
You may begin.
Hey, I've got a question.
Yes, you there, in the interesting clothes.
What's this item listed here on my scorecard? Chastity?
It's a joke, sweetheart. Say, what's wrong with you anyway? You're not some sort of government infiltrator, are you?
That's ridiculous.
Oh, yes? I am going to keep my eye on you, sweetheart.
It's not my fault you can't make a joke.
Yeah? You'll find out when we're finally in charge. Then you'll be the one singing a chastity tune.
That's it. I'm leaving now. Everyone else is already gone.
So they have. Very well dismissed.
He's a strange one. Hiya, girls. My name's Larry. Larry Laffer?
Laffer? Oh, that's a funny little old name.
I'll bet you're a funny little old fella, too.
Well, gee, I guess so. Say, don't I know you?
Oh, probably.
Yeah, you're famous, aren't you?
We're the Jugs. My name's Naomi. And this here's my daughter. Why don't you?
So, you ever heard our records, Larry?
So, why are a couple of famous singers like you taking a cruise?
Well, to be honest, Larry, fame can be a curse as well as a blessing. All that touring was just wearing us out.
Not to mention the fact that we can't show our faces in public again until the heat's off.
Why don't you hush your mouth?
Now, let's see. I've kind of forgotten. Which of you is the mother and which is the daughter?
Oh, shucks, Larry. Ain't you the little flatterer? I'm Wadoncha's mama, don't you know? Of course, we are dang near the same age. I had her on my first ovulation.
Heck yeah, I'm 19, and mama's been 29 for at least 5 years.
Wadoncha, you are not funny.
I notice you both have really large, hairstyles.
Yeah, you like them?
Well, they're sure, big. How do you get them that way?
Now, Larry, that's a little old showbiz secret.
To get it really big, I like to hang upside down.
Why don't you stop?
And to keep the hairspray from sticking to your outfit, you just about gotta be buck naked.
That's about enough, why don't you?
That's actually too much, but thanks for sharing.
Anytime.
So, what kind of music do you sing?
Both kinds. Country and Western.
Ass-kicking country western.
Why don't ya? We don't use that kind of language no more.
Sorry, Mama. Butt-kicking.
Now, see? Was that so hard? You probably know our big hit. Big hair and tangled limbs.
Well, it doesn't ring a bell.
What about, I got my panties round my ankles and pain round my heart? You know that one, don't you?
It sure sounds like a Grammy winner.
Oh, hon, it is. It is. When we finish that, there ain't a dry eye in the house.
So just what kind of music do you listen to, anyway?
Disco. Ka-chunk, ka-chunk. You know, some folks say it's coming back.
Well, I don't.
But see, I say it never left.
You are a funny little fella.
Hi, my name's Bill Gates.
Ah, cool. couldn't be. You're too geeky.
Slam dunk score.
You two must be performing here on the cruise.
We weren't gonna at first.
See, we're on vacation, don't you know?
Yeah, we was just wanting a break
from the pressures of fame.
But our manager insists we keep our act tight. So we decided to do one special show.
For the fans, don't you know?
God love them.
What do you mean, till the heat's off?
Oh, there was an unpleasant little inside end about a month ago. We was doing a benefit at a maximum security women's correctional facility.
We was trying to give our poor sisters a chance to forget their troubles.
It's always for the fans, don't you know?
That, and our manager said it'd be a cheap way to shoot our new cable special, Caged Heat, Jugs Behind Bars.
Why don't you? Who's telling the story anyway? Anyway, turns out that day we had a little trouble of fitting into our spandex costumes.
See, Mama'd been hitting them tour bus donuts again.
Why don't you shush? Anyhow, you know, the show must go on. So I just had one of our roadies spray us down with some silicone lubricant.
And we just slid right in.
Well, now there's an interesting image.
Anyhow, we had no idea those hot stage lights would trigger a chemical reaction between the spandex and that silicone lubricant.
Hoo-hoo-wee! That was something.
It did cause a commotion.
Oh, yeah.
So, what happened?
It's all kind of just a blur now.
Let's just say after that, everywhere we went, we was accosted by tabloid photographers.
We was mobbed.
And once they aired that videotape on A Nashville Affair, well, we just had to lay low for a while.
So here we are, just soaking up some rays and a kicking back.
Do you have any recordings I could listen to?
You know, I'd love to give you an autographed copy of our latest CD. This jug's for you. But we left for this cruise in such a hurry, we only had time to grab a few lacy nothings off in the bus.
Oh, that's okay. I far prefer the superior fidelity of 8-track.
Say, you are a funny little feller.
So why do you wear spandex outfits if it caused you so much grief?
For the fans, don't you know?
Yep, it's always for the fans. And because its mild corseting action keeps Mama out of them full figured sizes.
Why don't you? That'll be enough.
Well, it's been nice chatting with you.
Be sure you catch our show in the lounge tonight.
Y'all come back now, here.
Your attention, please. Is the proud winner of the
Whoa,
Scrabble
sorry,
competition.
Dude. You gotta stop here.
Why? What's wrong?
You can't enter the pool like that.
Like what?
Like that. You know, dressed.
Why not, dude?
Safety reasons, dude.
For sure. Safety reasons?
Way. Purser's orders. That polyester fabric could ignite in this tropical sun. So, drop 'em.
Well, I don't think I should enter naked. I mean, everyone would, stare, you know, at my, physical attributes.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, Dick, once I went into a restaurant that required a tie, and, well, because of my personal aversion to owning anything other than leisure wear, I never had a tie, so I...
Sure, I got courtesy loaners.
Oh.
This little dude right here is exactly what you need.
Oh, great. Of course I couldn't get a normal swimsuit. Can I at least have a towel to cover it up?
For sure! No problem, dude. Now, don't get it wet. It might shrink.
CyberSniff 2000.
Oh, I got sunscreen in my eyes. Boy! Oh, towel boy! I need a towel here, please, quick!
Oops! Oh, boy.
Oh, thank you. Well, well, what have we here? Is that your trunk, or are you just glad to see me?
And what's your name, little Babar?
Larry. Larry Laffer. And you?
Drew Barrymore. You know, I haven't seen a codpiece since I took Professor Lipkin's Minor Playwrights of the Late Elizabethan Period during my sophomore year at Barnard, and I've never seen one with such a cute African influence. You know, I'm quite interested in history, but I'm essentially ignorant of anything past the tertiary-level African tribes. Could you share a little of its immediate history with me? Perhaps its regional influences or its acquisition history?
Oh, well, the cabana boy gave it to me because I forgot my swimsuit.
Oh.
You don't have any clothing at all, do you, Drew?
Of course not. I love nudism so much that just as soon as I board ship, I get rid of every single piece of pesky clothing.
Good idea.
And I force my cabin boy to lock up my suitcase someplace where I can't possibly find it so I can spend the entire week here by the pool, naked. I eat, sleep, sun, and swim here, never leaving the comfort of the chaise. It may not be an ideal vacation for everyone, but for me, well, it's what I love most. Oh, this tropical sun is brutal. I hope you don't mind, Larry, but I need to spend a few minutes rubbing this sunscreen all over my naked body.
Need help?
No, but nice try. I really like the way it makes my skin glisten, you know? The way it brings out the soft little hairs on the back of my neck, my arms, my...
Stop! I can't take it!
Aw, I didn't realize I was being so hard on you. Excuse me, Larry. Here comes the waiter. This'll just take a second. Waiter! Oh, waiter!
Hey there, beautiful. What can I do for you?
I want a gigantic erection.
Looks like your little buddy there's got you covered, huh?
What? I said, bring me a gigantic erection.
Well, okay, baby. I'm your man.
Well, where is it?
I'm working on it. You mind moving that computer?
Look, I want a mixed drink, a cocktail, you know, lime juice, 151 proof rum, vodka, triple sec, mayonnaise with a hollowed out frozen banana to suck through. You know, a gigantic erection.
Okay, but it'll take a while, you know.
So, you recognize this as a con piece?
Of course. It's been a few years, but I believe my college text defined it as a pouch at the crotch of the tight-fitting breeches worn by men in the 15th and 16th centuries. It's from the Middle English word codpes. A cod, a bag, a scrotum, which came from the Old English word cod, meaning bag plus pes, meaning piece. Is that your understanding, Larry?
Yeah, thanks. Aren't you worried about overexposure?
Oh, no, not anymore. Sure, once upon a time, I had to limit my exposure, especially on a tropical cruise like this, but ever since I discovered this SPF 300, I have no problems at all. Every few minutes, I carefully, slowly, thoroughly rub it over every single inch of my naked body.
Aww.
And of course, my laptop computer here does offer some protection, although I do get a peculiar tan line.
Aww.
Larry, is my nudity making you uncomfortable? Is this hard for you?
No, it's been like this ever since I got here. So, did I ever tell you I know Al Lowe personally?
Who? Oh, I remember him. He came through here last November. Unimpressive.
Yeah, maybe.
Not him, Larry. You.
Drew, would you mind if I borrowed your book?
Not at all. I finished it.
I think I'll have a drink myself. Oh, waiter, I want the same thing the lady ordered.
Nice suit.
Please, bring me a gigantic erection.
Oh, that'll take a while for the bartender to fix. Wait right here.
I've never heard of a gigantic erection.
Oh, it's my favorite drink, Larry. Usually I suck it all down, then nibble for hours on its hard, frozen banana.
Oh, lordy, lordy, help me, lordy. Drew, I'm gonna go now.
Okay.
Your attention, please. Mark has just finished with a record high score in the nude curling competition.
Hold it! What do you think you're doing? You can't go in there. That's private. Why, them women could be naked in there, and the breast is just swinging back and forth with the nipple thing, and they could be hanging upside down again, and well, you just don't know.
Oh, sorry. I
was just looking for the head.
Don't you talk that nautical talk to me, bub. I'm just a plain old country boy. Oh, I don't need that. I got me a removable knot hole back there in the wall to the jug's dressing room.